Hey guys, welcome to a new episode of Conflicts. I have here the new humanoid robot from XYZ Robotics called Bolide. So let's go ahead and open it up and take a look.
All right, so let's just go ahead and make a slit. And then just go ahead and open that up. Wow, that looks so cool. So let's go ahead and take this out of its package. All right, so let's go ahead and look at the package. So this here is a do-it-yourself kit. Literally, you have to build this from the scratch up, which is actually a learning experience, but it's pretty cool. So it says here, imagination without limitations. The possibilities are endless. Have fun with your first humanoid robot. You can use the editor to make your own moves as you want. And in addition to that, you can actually print out your own body. So literally, these pieces are all interchangeable. So we'll actually do something about that later. So this does have 18 different servos, which is actually significantly more than any of the other robots we've done so far. The Alpha 1S actually has 16. So like I said, this is a motion editor as well as a 3D printable. It comes with the remote control as well as you can use the app. And then in the back it says here, got a little bit more details on it. So this one does have an accelerometer. So it actually prevents itself from falling down, which is pretty neat. In addition, it can help itself get back up. Has a speaker where you can play music. Has a buzzer so you can play a ringtone. So if your phone rings, it actually rings itself, which is really interesting. Does have Bluetooth connection, infrared sensors, so it can know the difference in distance as well. And then the eyes have blue and green light color, and the chest has red, green, and blue color for display. Now, in terms of the specs down here, nothing really other than what I already mentioned. The servos itself are 25 kilograms, and they're at 12 volts. Now there's a motion editor program that it also comes with, which allows you to create your own animations. And then these are some different bodies that you can print out using a 3D printer, which we'll actually do in another video. So let's go ahead and slide this out and take a closer look. Okay, so right off the back, it does have a warranty certificate on the top. And then it looks like we have a part list manual right here, showing all the different various parts that it comes with. So there's actually quite a lot, so not exactly sure how this is going to work out, but wish me luck. These are all the different body panels that it comes with, so we'll actually kind of show you that for a quick second there. Perfect. And then in addition to that, it looks like these are actually all the parts here. Now there is a lot of different parts in here, so I'm really curious to see how this works out. I've never done one of these before. And that's cool. Look, that's the remote control that it comes with. Now, this robot here is actually used in fighting as well, so kind of curious to see how this works out. Maybe I'll throw him against Alpha, who knows. But with that being said, wish me luck and cue the montage. Robot. It did take about 2 days to make it, which is actually quite a lot of time, but there's some pros and cons about that. Now, before we look at what's so cool about it, let's look at some of the downsides. Now, off the bat, I'm going to tell you, it's a lot of work to make a robot. There's a lot of intricate details and a lot of tiny, tiny screws. Some little tips that I noticed was right off the bat when I was making it, everything's pretty much labeled except for the screws. Now, I went ahead and labeled them myself with the corresponding letter and number before making it, and after that, it actually saved me quite a good amount of time. Now, in addition to that, when I actually had it ready to go, one of the tips about this is that if a servo is blinking red, right now they're all blinking white, if it's blinking red, that means there's an error, so you actually have to go back and figure out what you did wrong. Now, I encountered this twice once I finished building it. I had two servos that were blinking red. Turns out the connections were loose, so I tightened up the connections and it was good. Now, I did do a test run on it to see if it would actually perform the functions. However, after trying to get back up, the robot started blinking red in one of its servos.
Now, I actually contacted XYZrobot company to see what they can do, and they actually told me maybe one of the wires was a little tight. And I was actually the problem. After that, he's working like a charm, which is awesome. Their service is really nice. Just in case if you guys had any questions about it, always just send them an email and they'll actually respond back pretty quick. Now, the pros about this is the idea of being able to know what you build. There's a pride of ownership with it when you know you actually built it yourself. And being able to see it work is really phenomenal. In addition to that, the details and the essence of it actually is really cool. Now, compared to the Alpha 1S, I really do feel this robot is far more superior. Now, with the aspect of difficulty, obviously the Alpha 1S is pre-assembled versus this you have to actually build, but this does come in a pre-assembled kit. This, however, is more of their professional expert level, which is a little different. But you do get the whole aspect of being able to build your robot, which is, I think, really fun in itself. Now, in terms of the robot itself, this robot here actually has an accelerometer and is able to pick itself up if it falls over versus the Alpha 1S, which is a little bit more flimsy in my perspective. Now, this does have more servos, which allows it to have more range of motion. I do feel that the Alpha 1S software is easier to control. However, with this, you do get the remote, which is really neat because it allows you to take full control over him. And now note that these controls and these buttons are all programmable, so you can actually make your own actions. But aside that, the whole build aspect of him was really fun, and I think it's a really cool robot. Now, if you're a big model kit kind of person, or you just want to learn more about robotics, this is an excellent project, more or less, for anybody. Or if you're trying to do it with like your father or your daughter or your son, it's a lot of fun, and it's a big learning experience with a lot of trial and error. But the end result is pretty amazing. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump to part 2 for a play video. Otherwise, take care, guys. Bye bye.